Alright, I made it to Pascagoula. I think I'm saying it right. Probably saying it wrong more than likely, but here in Mississippi, getting ready to pick up the oversized load tomorrow in the AM. I'm at the customer. Just making this video to pretty much show the before and after, like how I run my truck when I'm running legal size loads. It's pretty much how everything look. And then how I run it, how I set up for the oversized. So pretty much just do a walk down the house. Set my flags up and everything. Alright. I always start from the front and work my way back. You see the flag holders are empty, my sign is folded up. So I just start from right here pretty much. Clip the zip ties. Damn. Front done. On to the back. Well, I still got to tighten those bolts up, but you get the idea. I tried to make everything so it's a quick setup and quick to unhook everything. So in the back, I just got this one rod right here that's not taped up to the ground, so no matter what it touches on the trailer, it's not gonna short anything out. That one is taped up because it's hot wire, so. I just hook that ground up. Now they get the light flashing. When I'm running legal loads, I just unhook that ground, the black wire, and I'm good to go. Now for my back sign, I got these. Got a quick disconnect up there. I need to put another one down here. I had one with quick disconnect on top and bottom, but somebody stole it. You know, typical Houston stuff. So I gotta start from the bottom with that. But yep, finna get this set up, and then I'll be right back. Bam. Now all I gotta do is unloosen that one, and then that side will be done. I'm gonna just show you on this side. All I gotta do is unloosen the washer real quick, no tool hit it. Well, the nut, I should say. Take the washer off, and then put it on. Now, the reason I put this on top and that on the bottom is after I'm finished with the load, if I wanted to, I could just take that bottom piece and just like the front, fold it up top to this one and roll like that. But I noticed the wind catch it a lot, so I just take it all the way off. Bam. Grab my drill. And this is only temporary until I get the things I need. I just came off a 2-week vacation. Yeah, if I can get this on here. Size, go figure. trying to do this and hold the camera. I'm gonna make a new hole. That was the original hole, but I'm gonna make a new one. Cause that one wasn't really, I think that hole was kind of gone. It doesn't need to be tight. It needs to be tighter than that though. Yep, that's good. Bam, sign is done. Now all I gotta do is put these flags on the rear. I won't be able to film and do that at the same time, but I will show you the finished product. That's pretty much it. All I do is take my bungees and just wrap it around top and bottom. That keep it in place. I mean, it's pretty sturdy. Same thing on the other side. So front done, back done. The only flags I got put on is the ones that go on the edges of the load, but I'm not loaded yet, so of course I can't put those on. Lights work. Good to go. Catch y'all tomorrow. right, so here's the load. Some bolt vanes. They 9.4 wide. I measured it. I got my permit for 9.6, so got a little wiggle room on there. Just three vanes and I think it's four boxes. It's a pretty interesting load. Yeah, I'm finna get on down Mississippi and wait on this Louisiana permit. Check this load, I'm finna hit the road, man. I'm already in Texas, it's time to go.
Drive time.